There is a very strong radical tradition in football as well. You know, you think of the, a number of groups of supporters get together, and I mean, there's a food bank collective across different clubs. You know, and people like the great Bill Shankly had a quote, and I can't remember it now exactly, but it's he believes in everybody working together. Everybody having a share of the rewards. That's how I see football. That's how I see life. You know,
it's the reason why I support Liverpool, Bill Shankly. I could say, come on, your heads, and mean it both in terms of football and in terms of public politics.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. But in all the, I mean, the right wing press always loves to highlight the racism, the right wing attacks, the right wing hooligans. There is a radical socialist element in football, and don't let's underestimate it. There's a whole business movement towards community ownership of football. It was was driven by a political belief in public ownership and common ownership, and the FC United that came out of the Manchester United when they were taken over by the Glazers. Glazers, in opposition to them, was driven by people who had a history of socialism. You know, so there is a very benign, positive, community orientated element amongst football fans, and you know that it gets overlooked because the right wing are obsessed by the right press, obsessed by the right wing. But let's not overlook that.